Bluegrass in Blackstock. As you know, the Blackstock community has been having bluegrass every Friday night for the last 11 years since 1998. Huge deal. Now, this is a story that has to do with every community in the TruVista viewing area. Fairfield, Chester, and Kershaw all have ties to Blackstock. Blackstock, as you know, is right on the Chester-Fairfield County line. It's actually in Chester County. And it also has a lot of musicians from it, from all three counties. In fact, we'll hear from the Maxie Branch Boys of Kershaw County later on in the broadcast. Now, to get to Blackstock, you can travel down either 97 or 321. It's in between those two highways, so again, travel down either Highway 97 or 321 in Chester, near the Chester-Fairfield border, and just follow the signs to Blackstock, and it takes place at the old Blackstock School Gymnasium. It's a beautiful building. They've done a wonderful job renovating it. For more on the history of the Blackstock School of Gymnasium, we go now to the story.
It was built in 1928. It was an old gym of the Blackstock School. Margaret knows. But anyway, the school has been torn down, but they preserved the gym. And Mac Traylor, a long resident from Blackstock, saw fit that we want to have a place to play, pick and play. So we started off with about 12 people in the back room, and people heard about it, and they kept on coming. Then it was put into paper, and Lord, they came in like it was cattle coming into stalls. It's coming in. We had to move out here and make this accessible.
All right.
But we used the back room first. See, a lot of these people went to school here.
There's our dancers right there.
She can't talk, but she went to school here. Her sister, Grace, went to school here. Who went to school at Blackstock? Is there someone else? Anybody else went to school here?
I don't believe I did.
Glenn, you didn't.
I don't think you did either.
We got handicap bathrooms. We got everything that's accessible. We got handicap. You come in the back door, wheel it right in.
Okay.
These are some of the nicest individuals you'll meet. You feel so welcome there. Now, I want to emphasize this is absolutely free to go to every Friday night. So it's a free event.
Well, I get here about 4:30 in the afternoon every Friday. We get the coffee going, two or three pots of coffee going, cut on the heat if we need it, have everything ready so when people start coming in, they know they're welcome.
All right, and then an amazing thing is not only is it free to get in, but they also have free food there, desserts, covered dish, supper, and coffee. So, it's an amazing thing. Now, being covered dish would be nice if you're going to take the food. You could bring something as well if you're going to go there regularly and eat the free food they're providing. Or if you're going to get coffee, it could be so nice to make a donation to help them pay for heating and upkeep of the building, that kind of stuff. But it is free. I mean, what a cheap way to get a food and have a wonderful entertainment, and it's every Friday night. But more about that food.
Well, it's all volunteer. We furnish all the paper goods, plates, cups, napkins, paper towels, everything that we need with the donation boxes. But the food is volunteer. Anybody that wants to bring something, and they do well. They've done well tonight.
Well, I'm a MC. I tell them when to get on, when to get off the stage, you know, and sometimes. And I sing.
I miss your pictures on the wall and your footsteps in the hall while I'm crying my heart out over you.
And cut up. And this old gal here got me in trouble. First time I came down here, she introduced me to my wife. We've been married 6 years now, but anyway, we get along good.
As we mentioned earlier, the Maxie Branch Boys come from Kershaw County to play there on a regular basis. People come from all over the region, in fact, and volunteer their talent to provide entertainment.
They just show up. They want to play.
We never know who's going to be.
We never know who's coming.
Never. Now, some of them come from far away. Some of them come from Camden.
Hickory Grove.
Yeah.
Lancaster, Monroe.
We talked about the Blackstock building being renovated, but the decorations on the inside, the cedar post stage, the records on the wall, has amazing decorations on the inside.
Our president, Barry Murray, and all the decorations just about belong to him.
Okay.
The pictures on the wall and the album, they're mine. I made most of those. And every season, which is coming up now, that tree is decorated. It will be St. Patrick's from next week.
Okay.
It's Valentine now.
So it's a year-round tree.
It's a year-round tree. The lights stay on, but someone decorates it.
Well,
Hazel
great.
Usually decorates.
And again, some of the friendliest people you can meet. It's such a welcoming atmosphere.
It's just the atmosphere here. It's just a family-oriented. It's old people like me. Children, people in wheelchairs, just
walking sticks,
walking canes. The atmosphere, there's no drinking and there's no smoking. Smoke outside.
Might not have smoking and drinking, but they have plenty and loads of dancing.
Yeah. Oh, Chief Blue over there, he could put the music on. He's in the back right now.
Okay.
From the Indian, from the reservation. He can play some music.
That's good.
We dance, clog, two-step, square dance.
So we got bluegrass, bluegrass, country, gospel, and whatever people want to sing.
That's right.
Okay.
It's not restricted to bluegrass. It just makes people happy. They got somewhere to go. They know it's clean and it's... It's just a lot of fun, isn't it?
And they know we're going to be here.
And they know we're going to be here every Friday night.
Every Friday night.
Except when Christmas falls on
Friday.
On Friday. Okay. We're going to put on a show for you.
Next up from Blackstock, we're going to hear from Chief Blue, the retired Catawba Indian Chief, who performs there now on a regular basis, getting the crowd rocking. We go now to Chief Blue.
Okay, real briefly, my name is Gilbert Billy Blue. I served as Chief of the Catawba Nation for 34 years. I retired about a year and a half ago. I've been playing music since about 1952, I guess. Had a band for 20 years that we played locally. And we just had a lot of fun doing that. And the nation right now is growing. We have a good education program. We have a health care center on the reservation now because of things that we put into place. So the nation is growing real good, and it's a real important part and integral part of the community. So it's just a pleasure to represent those people. And I've been coming down here since earlier this year. At first they didn't learn anything but acoustical instruments, and they kept asking me, and finally they said, bring your electric guitar and come on down, we don't worry about it. So I've been coming ever since on every Friday night.
Okay.
I like it all. I enjoy bluegrass music, but I grew up on country, and I was in the Navy from 1951 to 1960, so I grew up in the 50s with Fats Domino, Jerry Lee Lewis, and of course Elvis and all those people. So I know all their songs, and when we play for dances, that's the difference from just playing like here. When you play for a dance and people pay to get in, they want to dance. So a lot of songs I would like to sing, I can't because you can't dance to them. So I'm just used to playing dance music mostly. I think what I enjoy most about playing is just watching the people enjoy themselves. If they like to get up and dance and feel the rhythm of the music that we're doing, well, that's good enough for me. Well, there's two things that I enjoy about coming to Blackstock. Naturally, the thing is the music, but it's a family atmosphere. You know, there's no drinking, there's no smoking. I'm sure people go outside to smoke, but there's no drinking that I know of, never seen anyone. And it's just a nice, wholesome atmosphere for you to bring your family and just sit and enjoy yourself. And if you want to dance, fine. If you don't, just sit back and watch the others do their thing. So those are the two things I mostly enjoy about it. I appreciate the channels like you guys do for local stuff, because I know we get all the national and the world news that we want from the larger stations. But I think it's good that we have people like you folks that go around to the grassroots, if you will, the people that do things in the community, that we're such a part of the community, and that's what makes it so interesting. But appreciate you coming down here tonight too.
Well, I hate to be repetition tonight, but we have a request for one that we do about every week.
Kershaw County.
All right, tell us who y'all are and introduce yourselves, if you would, please. We're the Maxi Branch Boys from the Midlands of South Carolina.
Hi, I'm John.
Hi, I'm Tom.
How are you?
We're not at my dinner.
Mike. I'm Mike.
Mike. Over there.
That's Paul.
Paul Eagle, how you
Paul
doing?
Hi, Paul. How are you doing?
Good. Good. Tom, how you doing?
Good job.
Now we've been introduced.
Introduced, yeah.
Paul down there is the guitar player. He's been with us for about a year.
Yeah. Been a year?
Close.
Mike's the fiddler. He's from, by the way, Paul's from Michigan. Mike is the fiddler from Mississippi. This is Tom, the bass player, and I'm John, the banjo player. And Tom and I started the band about 20 years ago, and we've had a bunch of people. It started out as a jam session. We never really started to be a band, but it started out as a jam session, and a few core people came through and stayed, and that's how we got to be a band. And we started performing locally, and now we're all the way up here in Chester. He lives at Lake Watery.
I live in Elgin.
I live in Dalzell, which is in Sumter County.
It's the Elgin by Rudolph.
We play what we like to play, and it just happens to be mostly bluegrass, but we put in some country songs and some original stuff and some things that we've kind of made bluegrass. And we like to have fun with it. And that's it. That's yeah. What it's all about.
We always like said we're just a bunch time. Of old guys having a good time, you know. We have a good time playing the music, and we hope the crowd has the same good time seeing us play the music. Well, we play quite a bit in the Borkin Grill. We've been members of in the Borkin Grill for about the last 8 years, playing about twice a month. We also are every year in Miss Alice Borkin's float in the parade, the Borkin Mill Parade. If you haven't been to that, it's the Sunday before Christmas, usually about 2 o'clock in the afternoon. South Carolina's third largest parade.
Don't over Miss Alice here, you say third.
Well, that's what it turned out to be. They had 10 to 12,000 people there this time, lined up along the road about a 1 mile, maybe a mile and a quarter parade route.
Where else we play?
Hay bales, and where else we play?
Old folks' homes.
We play nursing homes, churches, assisted living homes. Right now we've got to get going in smoking and grilling in Dusty Bend. About every second Thursday night. We'll be there on the 5th of March, and be in the Barking Grill on the 6th of March.
Mike and Paul, would you let us get a word in edgewise, please?
To me, Mike just like to sit back and watch these guys yak. That's the whole thing.
All the talking.
My favorite song would probably be, probably got a few favorites, Orange Blossom Special, Angelina Baker, a lot of the old-timey music I like to play. I don't really play any of the new bluegrass, like the old-timey songs. I used to play guitar and mandolin, and I swapped over to fiddle, so I'm still learning, got a long ways to go.
He's got three fiddles, and he keeps buying them. He's hoping he'll buy a smart one. Here in Blackstock, people mostly would come, see Odell and Hazel, they run the place over here, and the people are just good here. It's a great senior citizen outlet.
The atmosphere's good.
Yeah.
Food's good.
Yeah.
Food's can't beat free food.
That's right. Food. That's right.
Well, anything y'all want to add?
Catch us on our website. If you Google us up and ask for the Maxi Branch Boys on Google, it'll take you to our website on MySpace. It'll tell you where we're playing, and even let you preview some of our songs that we have loaded on there.
And Paul's the webmaster.
Yeah, I guess that's what he calls on. If you've got a MySpace account, come on over and be our friend.
Okay. Well, we all have a different job. Paul, he's the electronics sound man and the webmaster. Mike, he's wardrobe. I do some of the arranging of the songs that we got, and try to keep everybody in the treasury, legal in the treasury. John, he does
the
booking.
Big job, the treasury.
John does the booking for us. If you want to do some booking in the Maxi Branch Boys,
call me, 803-499-2003.
If you see us playing, bring the instrument, join in.
Yeah,
you're always welcome to join in.
That's right.
It's all about having fun.
Listen to spoons.
Yeah, we don't like spoon players. Sorry.
Some glad morning when the slap is over, I'm on my way to the home that's next to shore. I'm on my way.
All right, so there you have it. I'd like to thank everybody in Blackstock for helping us have a wonderful time. Everybody there was so welcoming. We really enjoyed ourselves, enjoying the bluegrass music. Thank you to Harold Roberts for inviting us out to that event. And we'll certainly go back. So if you're looking for something for free and for fun to do on Friday night, you can't beat bluegrass in Blackstock. Contact us with other musical events. We love to cover, promote your event. Just let us know ahead of time so we can be sure to have enough time to do the segment before the event or to plan on being there to cover it. There's number two on your screen for that. We'll be bringing you a lot more updates as we have live musicians in our area. Okay, something fun to do on Friday night. And along with that, just want to touch on the fact that, as we know, some people like to say there is nothing to do here, blah, 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 blah. But I want to remind everybody of the old saying that bored people are boring people. In other words, there is plenty to do all the time if you are smart, creative, and don't let other people do the thinking for you. Remember to think for yourself. Now, here on the new show, I've brought you all kinds of fun things to do in a very short amount of time. We've been to the Shad Club at Legends. We've been to 321. We've been to APW Wrestling. We've been to Bluegrass and Blackstock. And we could go on and on and on. There are all kinds of things to do in our area. So, be creative. Create something for other people to do. Remember the mythical areas where people say there's lots to do. They didn't just magically get that way. They got that way because individuals took it upon themselves to create something for others to do. So, don't be fooling and thinking there's nothing to do. Look at the Bluegrass and Blackstock 11 years strong every Friday night. It is free and provides free food by people coming together and sharing food, cover dish supper. And there's all kinds of good ways to be creative and have stuff to do. Who wants you to think there's nothing to do? People that want your money. Because big business and government likes to convince us all that we need them to entertain us and take care of us so that we don't think for ourselves and continue to enrich them. But if we are creative, if we pull together, support our local communities and our local businesses, then it's amazing what we can do. So think outside the box. All right, now, sorry, I'll get off my soapbox now. Big news in our community. Speaking of big success, Great Falls Red Devils. In a year where they've been here in consolidation, maybe closing the schools and all that stuff, the Red Devil shone through by doing what they do best under Coach Smith, going to the state championship game. That's right, for the 17th time under Coach Smith, the Red Devils will be heading back to the state championship game to play Calhoun County. That will be Saturday at 1 o'clock in Columbia at the Colonial Center. We encourage everybody to go down there and support the Red Devils so they try to bring home a state championship game. TruVista Stone Productions will be covering the game. Stone Productions will have that game on TruVista next week. So watch Channel 39 to watch a replay of the state championship basketball game between Great Falls and Calhoun County. We'll also, on the news show next week, bring you an interview with the legend himself, Coach John Smith. Now, speaking of Great Falls and things to do, there is a rodeo coming up brought to you by the Great Falls Rescue Squad. The Great Falls Rescue Squad will be hosting the rodeo on March 13th and March 14th. Here's the information of where that rodeo will be and where you can go for more information on how you can attend that rodeo. Again, that rodeo will be brought to you by the Great Falls Rescue Squad. All right, well, thank you very much for watching. It is edging ever so much closer to spring. We did get hailed back with 15 degree weather and some snow, but it's fun to play in the snow. Wish we had a little more to sled in, but oh well, maybe next year. Let's bring on the warm weather now. Class of 99, be sure to get your money in. Clock is ticking on that. Don't wait. Well, thank you very much for watching. Remember, don't support the man. Buy local when you can. All right, and some people were disappointed. We cut a little early the other week when we ran down the hill, so we're going to run down the hill again for those individuals to show what happened when I got to the hammock. All right.
I'm making a commercial, y'all.
All right, I'm gonna do like I'm on the TV.
Hey, it's John Brown at The Furniture Place in Rock Hill. I said The Furniture Place.
King bed with rails, dresser, mirror, chest, and nightstand. Over $1,900 wholesale. We're selling it for $1,588 with two beds to choose from. 42-inch butcher block gathering table with four stools, retail $599. Our closeout price only $199.
The Furniture Place. If you buy anywhere else, you will pay too much. The Furniture Place. I-77, exit 82B, Cherry Road, Rock Hill.
Classic Metal, metal roofing and siding manufacturers lets the customer choose from different color rolls of steel. They then cut that to the size and the dimension the customer needs for their house or building. They even put the ribs on it right there in the store. It's forklifted for easy, no hands-on pickup. And they're all the accessories you need to get the job done right. They also sell metal insulation, metal tubing, steel doors, carports, and much more. Classic Metals, 803-789-5500.
Our daddy says, put your last clip on
first. Hi, this is John Shera, a local family dentist. I'd like to say congratulations to the Cyclone football team for a great year, but also wish much success to the remaining sports activities that will be going on the rest of the year, and encourage the community to get out and support them. I do thank the community for their support over the many years that I've been here in Chester, and hope we can offer dental care for years to come. Speaking of dental care, I do have one new instrument that I'm going to introduce, if Peter will allow me to do that. This is called a periolase, latest technique in treating periodontal disease. That's diseases of the gums. This instrument will treat periodontal disease without cutting or suturing, and supposedly makes it a much more pleasant experience with proven clinical results and very little post-op discomfort. So I'd encourage, if you're thinking about needing periodontal treatment, or you've been told you need it and would like another opinion or an alternative procedure to conventional perio surgery, I'd be glad to talk to you about it. And otherwise, everybody have a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Thank you.
Go Cyclones!